The historical foundations of the festival has been laid by German curator Florian Wüst. He presents a film program that includes views from the past and the present and alternates avant-garde with propaganda and documentary films. The festival exhibition is by British curator Benjamin Fallon, and it reveals, among other things, the talent with which capitalism sells itself and what the system's influence is on social ties. The Amsterdam Collective Monic consists of three people. They focus on the concept of labor, labor optimization from the Homo Sovieticus to cuppa soup.
Tonight opened, the Impact Festival opened tonight with Melle Smets and Joost van Onna's fantastic work, Smarty Turtle One. Let's look at a short trailer first. This is the opening act of the festival because you're touching a lot of essential questions about the capitalist system in a very visual and even funny way. Did you design this car?
For the festival?
No.
No.
In Ghana?
Apparently, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't know anything about cars, basically. But once we were there, we planned to make a car. That was the idea. But actually not to build a car, but to find out how does this place work. I mean, you have to imagine, you saw a bit of it. There are 200,000 people working in this Mad Max world. So for us, that was like a big blur. And we thought, how are we going to make sense of this? So that was our aim, to find out how it works. And then we thought, well, just order a car and follow the track, and then we'll find out. Mm-hmm. So that's how it started. Mm-hmm. But then they started to look at us, like, okay, well, you are here to build a car, so design one. And then I was like, oh, okay. And well, then we took off, and in 3 months, it became a roller coaster. And finally, I became a car designer. Yeah.
We translated certain sections into Dutch, and these are kind of posted around town. They're posted in these poster sites, so they'll appear and disappear. Maybe you'll catch them over the kind of next few days. The other aspect is we did a tour with them. This is three of the artists who were here, and they kind of spoke about this process.
It's a rich exhibition. It's playful at times. It's also very human. The role of human beings is not erased automatically as it is being done in the system so often. Can you comment on that finally, the emphasis on the human being inside the whole system?
Well, I mean, I kind of think that that's a very important aspect because it is what affects us kind of on, you know, without wishing to be like a humanist, but, you know, it is something which impacts the way we feel, the way we kind of interact one-on-one. Mm-hmm. You know, when we have this idea of competition kind of placed into our kind of social relations, then... and so I think it is from this perspective that we need to start and kind of start to understand things.
We're going to see a fragment of a Chinese artist architect who we filmed during our 6 month stay in China in 2009 and 10. And he's a real artist architect, but we asked him to play himself, and we also added some fictional elements. And I think we can tell later more about these elements when we've seen the fragment.
住户通过将自己和这个项目取得联系，他可以既是股票市场的投机者，同时又是艺术的赞助人，据说将成为他优雅品味的里程碑。
Okay, so we've been through this crisis, and there are all sorts of explanatory formats out there, and it's interesting to look at the different genres. One genre is that it's all about human frailty. I mean, Alan Greenspan took refuge in the fact it's human nature, he said, you can't do anything about that. But there's a whole world of explanations that kind of say it's the predatory instincts, it's the instincts for mastery, it's the delusions of investors and the greed and all the rest of it. So there's a whole range of discussion of that. And of course, the more we learn about the daily practices on Wall Street, we kind of figure there's a great deal of truth in all of that.
Faced with this onslaught of opposition, the pro-patent pharmaceutical industry turned to a British lobbyist, Paul Adamson, to swing parliamentary opinion their way.
Adamson persuaded 30 terminally ill, wheelchair-bound patients
who might benefit from biotechnology research
to greet members of the parliament
crucial votes
before crucial votes.
Why the singing voiceover?
Can't within the 3 minutes.
Because it's a bonus question.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Because we wanted to make a music video.
Mm-hmm. And it worked.
Guess so. Mm-hmm. Partly.
Ideology is not simply imposed on ourselves. We, in a way, enjoy our ideology. We are not dealing here with something which simply concerns the fragile psychology of a distorted person, what Travis in Taxi Driver is. It has something to do with ideology. All the ice in the world cannot kill a true idea.
The work we do and how we relate to the world is increasingly abstracted or becoming more abstract, and our labor itself is fragmented into smaller and smaller bits. For example, the factory line where the people from Ford, 5 people made one car, and now you have thousands of people doing minuscule little tasks, which are now also replaced by robots.
It's that the way we work and in which context we work becomes more and more part of this really big global economy.
Yeah.
So the part we play in that economy becomes, because the economy itself becomes bigger and bigger, so our part becomes smaller and smaller comparatively.
It's a functioning bar, and that's also what makes it nice for us to place our work inside of that environment, because people are actually working there. And we're not really interested in knowing what work is and in telling people what work is. We are really interested in, just as Joost said, investigating what it is.
Mm-hmm.
And
because this is the actual Theater Kicker foyer bar.
Yeah, this is it. So
it's not a separate work of art. It's
no, it has its own rules and its own, let's say, we are trying to kind of make a piece there, working together with the people behind the bar, which is a very interesting somehow choreography by itself, both social as well as workflow-wise, et cetera, et cetera.
Right, this house that you found on the Iraqi-Iranian border.
Right.
It's built by and for one man.
Yes.
And you regard this, and it's been included in the exhibition, as a symbol of, let's say, existentialist-inspired individualism post-2003.
Yeah, it's very interesting. Thanks for the question, because you let me to let me also at that point where that fetishizing of individualism was used also by the different Western medias, also like after, for example, Rumsfeld's visit 1983, many films came to Baghdad, and through the TV we were seeing how ballet dancers from the Soviet Union, when they go to the West and they come back, they dance in a more individual way. So for us was always...
And 2003, of course, for a lot of Iraqis, they thought, okay, now we're going to be capitalists, we're going to be free, we're going to be individual, we're going to buy whatever we like.
Exactly. So
it's, and we're going to have a house for one's own instead of sharing it with the whole family and the big community.
Exactly, like you see the symptoms of small, like one room apartment, and you can see also small pots. No, you don't have to cook for many people, you know. But I mean, I was just interested in these small things also,
When you entered the room, you saw work projected that has been developed for us by the Bureau d'Etudes. And I hope we can get it on the screen again now. It's an immense infographic, as you can see, and made by Bureau d'Etudes, the Paris-based artists Leonore Bonaccini and Xavier Fourt. For the last several years, the French group has been producing cartographies of contemporary political, social, and economic systems. The visual analysis of transnational capitalism is based on extensive research and is usually presented in the form of large-sized murals. Impact invited them to develop a visual analysis of the psychology of the crash. You can now see this infographic world government projected here, and it's also on display in Kick a Small Hole, and you can see it during the whole festival. Thanks all for attending the opening program of the Impact Festival, and I hope to see you again for the upcoming days to enjoy the Impact Festival 2013. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.